Joe Biden as Vice President of the United States was a center point. It was almost the planet around which these business activities moved.
All right, so we can bifurcate the people. This is all separate from what the New York Post was reporting this week. This is separate from what we knew earlier, and it's separate from Ron Johnson and Chuck Grassley's report that they put out, 87 pages, which talked about, well, Russian oligarchs, Kazakh oligarchs, the $3.5 million payment with the former First Lady of Moscow, Chinese nationals, $100,000 shopping spree, Russian nationals, Kazakh nationals, Ukrainian nationals. How much money are we talking about here? And were all three of them involved in all of these endeavors?
Well, it kind of jumps around, but let me just make clear, these are all separate emails from the New York Post and what the Senate did, but they all reinforce the same. I mean, to take for an example, Ms. Batarina, the Russian oligarch linked to organized crime that the Senate said sent $3.5 million, that's based on Treasury Department documents, we'll be rolling out a story in a couple of days demonstrating that their relationship, meaning Hunter and Devin Archer's relationship with Elena Batarina, goes way back, and they were performing a number of banking and other financial services for her, services that they had trouble doing, by the way, because several banks did not want to work with her because the money was seen as dirty.
So, all right, so literally, these nationals were allowed access to Biden inside the White House, according to these emails. I guess my next question is, if both of Hunter's business partners are convicted, how did he go scot-free?
Exactly.
Well, that's the question, Sean. There was a trial in 2016, and we actually have gone through the notes of that trial. And what it demonstrates is that Hunter Biden's fingerprints are all over this. He is named repeatedly in the court trials and documents, but he was never charged by the prosecutors in New York.
All right. Great work, Peter Schweitzer. We'll have you back next week with this next report. All right, when we come back, she is the Trump Town Hall audience member everybody was talking about, nodding her head in agreement with the president. She will join us next, exclusively, right here on Hannity.